node voltage method, which is very powerful and very important method. Also today, we are going to cover the second sister or the second brother of the nodal analysis. Basically, we have two very powerful techniques that almost can solve any problem. Yani any problem can be solved using either the nodal or the mesh analysis. These are two powerful methods, but not necessarily they are the quickest method. Yani sometimes the basic rules like KCL and KVL could be faster in solving some problems compared with nodal and mesh analysis. And what I'm saying, node analysis and mesh analysis can solve any problem, but not necessary in the shortest time. It might take longer time. But if you are confused, you can choose either nodal or mesh analysis. So what is the meaning of, or what do we mean by the mesh current method? What is a mesh? Anyone remember what is a mesh? What's the definition of a mesh, ya shabab?
Something closed, maybe.
So what is the difference between mesh and the loop? How many mesh we have in this?
Mesh only. Four meshes.
We have four meshes. And how many loops?
So many.
How many loops?
Many.
We have so many loops. Many in this loops. Circuit, is in this circuit, you can say that this is a loop. This is a loop. Any closed line, closed path is a loop. But how many mesh? We have four meshes only. So our concern, ya shabab, is the mesh, not a loop. A mesh is a closed loop, but cannot enclose any other loop. And we cannot have another loop inside this mesh, or we cannot have another mesh inside a mesh. Okay, shabab. So our interest is the mesh, which cannot enclose any other loop or any other mesh inside. Yani for a loop, you can have, if you take this is like a loop, it has three mesh inside, or it has three loops inside. But a mesh contains only, it is only one mesh. We cannot have anything inside. Tamam? Okay. So here we have two mesh only. In this guy, we have four mesh. Tamam. What you know is that we have a branch current called IA. We call it branch current or current through element. And we might call it current through element. Current through element. So we have IA, we have IB, and we have IC. This is a branch current. We call it branch current. Today, inshallah, we are going to take new concept of a current. The new concept is what we call this, look at this current, ya shabab. It's like virtual current, imaginary current. This current are called, what is the name of this new current?
Mesh current.
Khalid, you are saying this is the mesh current. So the new current we take today, ya shabab, is the mesh current. A mesh current is what you can see. Like a current in a mesh, defined either clockwise or counterclockwise. Yeah, it could be CW or CCW. You choose, yani it is not necessary to be clockwise. It could be the other way around. So what is the meaning of this mesh current? Or let me be, what is the relation between a mesh current with branch current? What is the difference between a mesh current with branch current? That's old fashioned. This is what you know, the branch current. The new fashion today is the mesh current. We are going to deal with the mesh current. So what does this mean? Why we are doing this? Why we define a new virtual imaginary current? Let's see. So what is the relation between the old fashion current and the new mesh current? Look at IA. What is the relation between IA and the mesh current? IA and equal. I1. IA equal to I1. It's clear. IA equal to I1. As you can see, IA, this current equal to I1. What about IC? IC equals to, what's IC here?
I2.
Compared to the mesh current, IC is I2. Clear. IA is I1. Because I1 is the only current in the 2 ohms. We have no other current in the 2 ohms based on this definition. And I2 is the only current in the 4 ohm and in the source 5 volt. So IA is I1 and IC is I2. تمام؟ What is IB? What is IB? What is IB?
I1 minus I2.
IA minus IC. IB from this circuit يا شباب. IA minus IC. KCL. IB is IA minus IC. And IA is I1 as we said. And IC is I2. So the branch current moving here. The current moving here. Is simply I1 minus I2. Look, I1 is moving down. I2 is moving up. So it's very simple. Once you know how to relate elements current, it's called elements current, with the mesh current, once you know these three equations, so the remaining is easy. The next stuff is easy. You just to know the relation between the elements current and the mesh current, the new mesh current. These three equations. Any question, Shabab?
Yes, Dr. What if IB was going up?
If IB is moving up, okay. I will change assume IC is moving up. What's IB in this case? Look at IB. IB is moving
up. Minus
A. IB is moving up. I'm assuming IB is moving up. So it will be I2 minus I1. It will be I2 minus I1. Yeah, and IB is assumed to be moving up here. So I2 is moving up in this resistor and I1 is moving it down. So it will be I2 minus I1. And you will take the mesh current in the same direction with positive sign, the other mesh current with a negative sign. In case IB is moving up, it will be I2 minus I1. It's very, very easy and very, very important. Very, very easy and very, very powerful. You must be able to relate or write the elements current in terms of the mesh current. Any question, Shabab? Should we proceed? Where are the other people? Any question? Here we have, so how can we solve a circuit using the mesh technique? Look here, Shabab. Here we have IY branch current, IW branch current, IZ branch current, IX branch current. So we have four branch current. We have, as we can see, we have IX, IW, IV, IY, and IZ. How can we write this current in terms of the mesh current? I need to express IX. What is IX, ya shabab, in terms of the mesh current? Look at IX. Look at IX. What is IX in terms of I1, I2, I3?
I1.
IX equal to I1. Is it clear? Look at IX, Shabab. IX is I1. What's IW? IW is the current moving here. IW, the branch current.
I3.
So IW is I3 minus I1. IW is I3 minus I1. Is it clear, Shabab? Look at IW. I3 minus I1. Abdullah Shukr. What's IY?
IY will be I3. Minus I3.
Excellent. Badr Shimri. What's IZ? Badr.
Minus I2.
IZ, yeah, Badr. Look at IZ. Look at IZ, moving down. So it will be exact, minus I2. What else? It's minus I2. And we have I1 also. Look at I1, yeah, Badr. I1 is moving down. I1 is moving down, moving like this. Tamam? And I2 is moving upward. So IZ will be?
I2 minus I1?
Exactly. I1 minus I2.
Okay.
So I1 is moving down, yeah, look at I1. And IZ is moving down, right? IZ moving down. I1 معي, with him, same direction. I2 هو الopposite. يبقى IZ, so I1 minus I2. تمام يا شباب? This equation. Any question? Because if you don't understand this, you cannot proceed. If you don't understand how to express the element's current in terms of the mesh current, يعني you cannot proceed with this.
Doctor.
Yes.
Can you show with numbers examples like how do you solve?
Example what?
An example of mesh current.
Yes, we will solve this just introduction. Well, it's still in the introduction. أي سؤال يا شباب في هذا؟ Any question?
دكتور.
Yes.
دكتور, can you go to the previous slide?
Okay. This or this?
No, no, the other one. Okay. Can you repeat this part? IA equal to, sorry, IB equal to IA minus IC. Just quickly.
Look at IB, يا أحمد. IB is moving down, right?
Okay.
IB equal to IA minus IC. Correct? This is what we know.
True, yeah.
IB, IA minus IC. IA was found to be I1. YC can is move I2. Right? Do you agree on this?
Yes.
IA is I1. YC is I2. يبقى IB اللي هو IA minus IC, I1 minus I2. Okay? Without okay. even looking at this, يعني it will be very quick يا شباب يعني. IB is the current moving down. You need the current moving here, right? So this current is I1 minus I2 based on the mesh current. تمام؟ Because we are going to deal now with the mesh current. Mesh current is the new current that we will use. We will use mesh current. And forget now, forget about this IA, IB, IC. Forget about it now. We need to focus on the mesh current. We will take KVL. Now we take KVL using mesh current in new style. Because this new style will make it very easy. Later on, after you find the mesh current, and after we have I1 or I2, you can easily find any other current using the relation I have written here. يعني هو اللي أنا بقول what I'm saying يا شباب. Did you get it, أحمد?
Yes, doctor.
What I'm saying يا شباب, we will solve the problem by finding the mesh current. Mesh current اللي هو إيه? I3, I1, I2. After you find the mesh current, you can easily go back using this equation and find any branch current. Go back by the old style, old fashion, اللي هو IX, IY, IZ, IW. But first you need to find the mesh current. تمام؟ It's very, very easy, very, very easy, and very, very powerful.
Doctor,
yes.
Is the mesh current equal to the sum of the currents in that loop?
The mesh current is the current in this loop, and it is related to the branch current, as we expressed here using this equation. I don't understand what you mean the total current in the loop. What do you mean?
If I add IW and IZ and IX, would I get I1?
No. I1 is involved. Look at I1. I1, يعني, I1 equal to IX. I1 equal to IX. تمام? And IZ is I1 minus I2. It will be clear then. Now, we need to solve this circuit. We need to find the mesh current, I1 and I2. And I have defined the mesh current. I need to find I1 and I2. What should I do? I will do what I have done before. We will take KVL in mesh 1. Look at mesh 1. Mesh 1. Take KVL. What is KVL? Minus 10 plus VA plus VB equal to 0. Look at this equation. So it is minus 10. Plus 2IA plus 6IB. تمام? This is a question we had before. Chapter 1. Minus 10 plus 2IA plus 6IB. Everyone agrees? Now, I need to rewrite this equation using mesh current. IA will be replaced by, what's IA here? IA will be replaced by?
I1.
IB replaced by?
I1 minus I2.
Exactly. That's it. Now we are done. تمام? So it is the same equation. No, chapter 1. This is chapter 1. What I will do, I will replace IA by I1, YB by I1 minus I2. That's it. This clear? طيب. So what will be the new equation? هي بقى المعادلة الجديدة. The new equation is, you will do nothing but replace IA, احنا قلنا IA هو I1, right? IA is I1. وIB هو I1 minus I2. So the new equation is, that's it. This is the mesh equation. This is KVL using mesh equation. KVL using mesh equation. Why I write case LA? I think. Oh, anyway, so I have replaced IA by I1, YB by I1 minus I2. Is this clear, ya shabab? This equation is clear for you?
Yes, doctor.
Yalla. أي سؤال يا شباب؟ أي سؤال؟ يعني only this equation. Is this equation understandable? مفهومة؟
Yes.
يبقى surprise بقى اللي جاية. Add I1. فين I1 هنا؟ I1 2 6. 2 plus 6. 8 I1. I2 minus 6 I2 equal to 10. تمام؟ Now. Okay يا شباب. Forget about this. We don't need to rewrite this every time. No need for this. This is for baby, for babies. We are now grown up. So forget about this. How can you write this equation just by looking at the circuit? Yeah, I don't need to go through all of this. Just write, how can we write this equation using the circuit? 10 is written here, the voltage. You are moving clockwise. So the positive sign is the second sign. So you have 10. I1, look at I1. I1 is moving through 2 plus 6. Yeah, look at I1. I1 is moving this way. So we have 2 plus 6 times I1. Well, I2, negative 6. Because I2 is moving in the negative side, in the opposite side. Remember, I take the current positive in clockwise. This is my assumption. Yeah. So I1 times 8 minus I2 times 6. So I can write this equation right away. You don't need to write all of this. تمام? You understand this? Maybe this is a little bit confusing. يعني maybe what I'm saying is that forget about these two equations. Can you just write this equation from the beginning? Start by this equation. What should we do? We will take the clockwise. So you have negative 10 plus 2 I1 plus 6 I1 minus I2. You can just start from here. Then add all the I1 and I2 together. Later on, inshallah, after some practice, the secret word is practice. After some practice, you will find yourself, يعني very easily you can start by this equation. يعني later on, انت سوف تجد نفسك very easy you can do write this equation without writing the first one. But for the time being, just to learn, we are new, so minus 10 plus 2 IA plus 6 I1 minus I2 equal to 0. This is the first equation, shabab. What about KVL in the other loop? KVL in the other loop. So we will have minus B plus VC minus 5 equal to 0, chapter 1. Yeah, and if you take the loop like this, minus 6 IB plus 4 IC minus 5 equal to 0. Look at this equation. Everyone agrees with this equation? Everyone agree with this equation? KVL in the other loop. So minus 6 IB plus 4 IC minus 5 equal to 0. What's the next step, shabab? So I have written KVL, chapter 1. This is chapter 1, KVL. What's the next step? Replace the branch current by the mesh current. Replace, what's IB here? What's IB to be replaced by? IB is, ya shabab, yalla, Abdurrahim, ya Abdurrahim. What is IB in terms of the branch, in terms of the mesh current, ya Abdurrahim? Hello, Abdurrahim, Abdulwahab.
Ayo, doctor.
Ayo, Abdulwahab. What is IB in terms of the mesh current, Abdulwahab?
IB?
Oh, look at IB, Abdulwahab. IB is moving down. What's IB?
I1.
انت معانا ولا ايه؟
ايه معك. انا بتقول IB. I1.
تفضل. IB in terms of the mesh current. يعني now أنا I have written عبد الوهاب the equation of KVL. It's KVL in this loop. So very easy, KVL. Minus 6 IB plus 4 IC minus 5 equal to 0. Now I need to replace the branch current, low IB و IC, with the mesh current. So IB equals to?
IB اللي هو IA minus
minus IB. IB is I1. IB يا شباب is I1 minus I2. And because I'm replacing the branch current, that old fashioned, that old بتاع زمان. Now we are using the new mesh current. So IB is replaced by I1 minus I2. IC will be replaced by IC will be replaced by
doctor,
yalla,
replaced by I2.
Exactly. That's it. IC will be replaced by I2. This will give me a new equation. Replace IB by I1 minus I2 and replace IC by I2. This will give you a new equation, Abdul Wahab, which is the new equation is this equation. So IB is I1 minus I2, YC is I2. That's it. So now you have two equations, two unknowns. Now you have two equations, two unknowns. This equation down here and the top equation. You have two equations, two unknowns. The two unknowns are I1 and I2. You can proceed. Wait, please. You can proceed by the last equation we have. You can collect I1 and I2 together. So now you have the two equation. Now you have the two equation, shabab, which is this is one equation, second equation. Two equations, two unknowns. What are the two unknowns? I1 and I2. Once you have I1 and I2, job is done. You can find in other current. Once you have I1 and I2, you can find IA, IB, IC, and that's it. Yes, shabab. Who have question?
Yes, why didn't you put I2 minus I1 in the second current?
I am talking about IB. You talk about IB, right? IB is moving down. IB is moving down. And I1 is moving down. So it will be positive I1. I2 is the other way around. I1 is moving down with IB. So IB is I1 minus I2.
Okay.
It needs some practice, shabab. As I said, after the class, just sit for 1 hour, repeat this problem, and you will find it very easy. You just need some practice. You will find it very, very clear. Tamam. So at the end of the day, you will have two equations and two unknowns. Now you can solve for I1 and I2. My question is, forget about all I said. Now, can we just start by writing these two equations without writing in other equation before? We need to learn how can I write these two equations without writing all I have written. Look at loop one. What is loop one? Look at loop one, mesh one. So you have 10, you move clockwise. So plus 10 equal to I1. I1 is moving in 2 plus 6. صح? Look at I1. I1 is moving in 2 plus 6. So you have 8 I1. What about the 6 ohm? Do you have another current in the 6 ohm? We have opposite current, minus I2. So minus 6 I2 equal to 10. This equation can be written only from mesh one. Directly, just forget about all the other equations. I1 is moving clockwise. So 10 equal to 2 plus 6 is the two resistor that has I1. I1 is moving in 2 plus 6. When negative I2 is moving in 6, so minus 6 I2 equal to 10. What about the other mesh? Look at the other mesh. We are moving clockwise. So plus 5. Equal to what I2 is moving in 6 plus 4. So you must have 10 I2. Look down the equation down. I2 is moving in 6 plus 4. 10 I2. And the 6 ohm has I1 in the other direction. So minus 6 I1. And what I'm saying is this is, you can very, very quick write the two equations in no time. It will take 2 seconds to write these two equations. 1 second and 1 second. Then you have two equations, two unknowns, just solve the two equations. If you are confused, you can write this equation. Look, this equation is a little bit easier. Look at this equation. And if you are confused, you just write this equation. So take KVL here. Minus 10 plus 2 I1 plus 6 I1 minus I2. You are moving clockwise. So when you take the voltage here, it will be I1 minus I2 times 6. And this equation here is a little bit easier. As I said, after some time, after a few days, you will be able to write this short equation very quick. تمام يا شباب ولا ايه? Any question? أي سؤال? طيب, we need to write the mesh equation of this circuit. We need to write the mesh equation. So first, you need to define three current. Clockwise or counterclockwise. You could have defined I1's other way. I1 could be this way. You could have this is clockwise, this counterclockwise, whatever. You are free. Not insist all of them to be clockwise. To be easy, I define all of them clockwise. What's the next step, shabab? How can I write the mesh equation? Anyone can help me? Who can help me? Raise your hand if you can. يلا شباب مين تاني يلا يلا بسم الله تعالى بالله يلا وني تو لازم شي كويش ماجد
يس
مش equation for مش one مش one يا ماجد
for I for I one
exactly
minus minus eight plus for six I one minus
excellent.
six I two
exactly so look at this loop شباب look at what we are doing here we are moving clockwise so four I one minus eight plus six I1 minus I2. مين صالح مش 2 يا صالح مش 2 هي لا صالح
minus 6 I1
اوكي minus 6 it's better to start by 6 say 6 6 ohm
اوكي
بعدين احنا we're moving clockwise يبقى 6 ohm times
6 ohm plus 8 ohms for I2
Okay, so 6 plus so 8 times 14, I2, 14 four, I2.
Yes, and minus 6 I1.
Minus 6 I1.
Equal minus 12.
Equal, exactly. What you said is correct, but let's make it easy for us. We can write, we are moving clockwise, the shabab here. Look here. So I will go in 6 ohm. 6 ohms times I2 minus I1. Yeah, look, I'm moving this way. So 6 ohms times I2 minus I1. Plus, I'm moving the 8, plus 8 times I2 minus I3. Look at the 8 ohm. 8 ohm has two current, I2 minus I3. Minus I3 plus I2. Plus 12. Plus 2, you take the first sign. تمام? You are taking the first sign. Some student might say, I will make it easy for, I don't like to write it this way. So go back to mesh one. If you look at mesh one, the current I1 is moving in 4 plus 6, right? I can write just 10 I1. Just write 10 I1. Because I1 is moving in 4 plus 6. What else? And the current in 6 ohm, we have minus I2. So minus 6 I2 equal to 8. Yeah, and instead of writing the top one, you can just write the bottom one. Very quick. Very, very quick. Very easy, wallah. يعني very easy والله. ال current I1 moving in 4 plus 6. So يبقى 10 I1. ده مش 1 we are still in مش 1. So current I1 4 plus 6 10 ohm minus 6 I2 equal to 8. تمام؟ يعني what I'm saying is no need to write, you can write this right away. Or if you are confused, you can just write as we did. You can start by this equation a little bit easier. يعني. And 4i1 minus 8 plus 6 i1 minus i2. And the other equation, mesh 2, ya shabab, is 6 i2 minus i1 plus 8 i2 minus i3 plus 12. You take the first side. What about mesh 3? Who can help me? Musab. Yeah, Musab, you are here?
Yes, yes.
Mesh 3, ya Musab. This mesh, ya Musab.
Yes, 10 i3.
Minus 10 I3, exactly, 10 I3. Minus 8 times I2. So look at I3, يا شباب, I3 is moving in 2 plus 8. So 10 I3 minus 8 I2, because we still have I2. Minus 8 I2 equal to?
Minus 8.
Minus 8, exactly. And what is, or make it easy for you. Start by 8, move clockwise in 8. So 8 has two current, I3 minus I2. You can write 8 times I3 minus I2. تمام? Then plus 8 plus I3 times 2. Yeah, this is the equation. So again, شباب, I move clockwise. So 8 times I3 minus I2. And أنا ماشي clockwise. I will take I3 minus I2. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم plus 8 plus 2 I3 how many unknowns I have
three unknowns.
So we have 3 unknown 3 equations 3 unknowns how long this will take how long do you need to write the equations and solve the three equations How long this will take?
Three.
Write
5 minutes.
I can take the three equation and solve them. How long this will take?
3 minutes.
Let's say 6 minutes. I will assume six, even to 7 minutes. Yeah, for average student. Talk about average student. تمام. Average student will take 6 or 7 minutes. Using mesh. What about if you use node? Node analysis. How long it will take if you use node? How long it may take if you use node analysis? Small exercise. Repeat this problem. Of course, يعني using mesh after you find I1, I2, I3, you can easily find the current in any branch. يعني بعد ما after you solve this three equation, what is the current in the 6 ohms? What's the current in the 6 ohms? If you need to find the power in the 6 ohms, you need to find the current. What's the current in 6 ohms? What's this current?
I1 minus I2.
I1 minus I2. So once you have the mesh current, شباب, once you have the mesh current, you can easily find the current in any branch and then find the power, whatever you like, you can do. طيب, المش current will take 6-7 minutes. I need you to, at home, after you finish, repeat using Nodal and see how long it will take. I expect Nodal to take 2 to 3 minutes. You try it. But my expectation is that Nodal will take less time. Why Nodal might take less time? Why node voltage will take less time?
These equations?
Huh?
It takes 2 equations.
Because we have many voltage source. Look how many voltage source I have. I have 1, 2 voltage source. So make it like a rule. When you have voltage source in the circuit, this means nodal might be easier. When you have more voltage source, nodal analysis might be easier. When you have more current source, mesh analysis might be easier. Okay? You will get this by experience. يعني by experience, you will see the problem and say, I should use mesh. No, I should use node. Remember, شباب, it's about time. It's about, you can solve any problem. Might take you 1 hour to solve one problem. It's about how long it will take from you to avoid wasting time. The exam was tough yesterday. How was the exam? Medium. Huh? Medium. Average, alhamdulillah, it was not tough, yeah.
Yeah, average.
Alhamdulillah. You are expecting a full mark from many. Inshallah, yeah. I will try to upload the grades today. I will try. I will do my best. Yeah.
Doctor, what about the grades for quiz 2?
I will grade it soon. I should grade it manually. Because if it is manually, it takes time. If it is by blackboard, it is done automatically. So we pay the price. I like you to write solution full answer. So you will have partial grades, yeah. But sometimes it might take some time for me to grade. But inshallah, okay. I will do my best, yeah. Sorry. Okay, شباب. So as I said, please try Nodal and see how long it will take. Here, find the current in each element. Find the current in each element. What is the meaning of the current in each element? Hello, I1. But then I1 minus I2. I2, I3 minus I2, I3. This is the current in each element. So no, I don't want mesh current. I need the current in each element. So it is assumed to be, and the circuit is given like this. So I need you to find I1, I1 minus I2, I2, I3, all this current. Tamam? What should I do? What techniques I should use? You need to think. You have a direct method. You have Thevenin, Norton, superposition, nodal analysis, mesh analysis. We have many techniques, mashallah. Which technique to choose? I'm going to choose the mesh current. So I need to define I1, I2, I3. Look, I defined I1 to be clockwise, I2 clockwise, I3 clockwise. I could do the other way. I could define one of them to be counterclockwise. Yeah, not necessarily all of them clockwise. So let's start. Who can help me with mesh one? The question of mesh one, شباب. يلا, مين can help me? Raise your hand. Raise your hand, شباب. يلا شباب. يلا شباب. Who can help me? only six people. What about other people? Just give it a try. يعني. You might do mistakes. It's okay. Yeah, try with me. Even if you do mistakes, it's okay. Special garden. فيصل لا فيصل مش ساعدني يا فيصل ساعدني ليتس تراي مش وان يا فيصل لوك ات اي 1 اي 1 از ذا كرنت موفينج ان ذس لوب كلوك وايز ان ذس مش كلوك وايز اي 1 از موفينج
اي 1 ار 1
ها اوكي
اي 1 ار 1 ماينس في اس 1
اي 1 ار 1 ماينس في اس 1 اكزاكتلي
بلس في اس 3
بلس في 3 كوركت
بلس اي 1 ار 3
بلس I1 R okay R3 is having two current يا 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 فيصل R3 is having I1 minus I2
I1
no?
yes yes I1 minus I2
so it will be R3 times I1 minus I2
then plus R4 I1 minus I3
no no I1 minus yes yes you are correct plus I4 I1 minus I3
that's it
equal to zero this is mission number one يا شباب this is mission number one Who can help me with mesh number two? Mesh two, يا شباب. This mesh up there. يلا مين؟ حسن الكويعي. حسن. يا حسن.
Yes, doctor.
Mesh two, يا حسن.
Mesh two.
Start by R5. What is the current in R5, يا حسن?
Current اللي هو I2
I2
أيوة.
وبعدين
وبعدها هنا ال V
minus VS2
أيوة
minus VS2 وبعدين دلوقتي أنا ماشي في R2 I will go in R2 أيوة.
هنا أخذ اللي هو ال I3 minus I2 صح؟
you can take it it will be with negative sign يعني you will take negative R2 times I3 minus I2
أيوة.
Or we can make it يعني because the box solution is a little bit different. When you move in R2, you will have I2 minus I3. So we can say plus R2. Look, Hassan, R2 times plus R2 times. What is the current in R2, Hassan? I2 minus I3.
أيوة.
Is it واضح يا حسن? I2 minus I3.
أيوة.
Okay. And R2. Has two current I2 in the same direction minus I3. Then Hassan, إيه تاني?
بعدها R3
plus R3 times
هنا I2 minus I1.
Exactly. برافو حسن. Very easy. يعني I always take the positive yeah. sign as you can see with the resistor. So I take the current in the same direction. You are moving clockwise. You will take I2 minus I3.
هنا باقي في ولا V3
minus V3 minus V3 so as Hazard said when you move like this so R2 has two current low I2 minus I3 okay or minus R2 times I3 minus I2 it's up to you but يعني, to be easy we always use the positive sign with the resistor then you move in R3 look in R3 what's the current in R3 when you move this way I2 minus I1 Or I1 minus I2 with negative sign. And the same for mesh number three. So you have three mesh. You will have three equations in three unknowns. You will solve it using calculator or using a matrix method. Maybe you try repeat this using nodal analysis. And in a circuit, try repeat using nodal and see how long it will take. Yeah, see how long it will take using nodal analysis. Do you think it will take shorter time with the nodal? Do you think it will take shorter time with the nodal?
Yes.
Hmm?
There are many batteries, so yes.
Remember the difference between this circuit, the previous one here. This circuit was easy because the voltage source are between two essential nodes. Yeah, the voltage source is between two essential nodes. If you have a resistor here, it will be tougher. If you have a resistor here, using nodal will be tough. Mesh might be easier. يعني, it is easier using a nodal if you have only one source between two essential nodes. Between two essential nodes. If you have a resistor here, it will make it يعني, more complicated to use nodal. It will work, but it might take longer time. You try it. Repeat this using nodal. Repeat using nodal. And see how long it will take. My expectation it will take longer time than mesh. will take longer time because of this resistor series with the voltage source. Anyway, write the mesh current and determine the current I. We need to find the current I. Where is the current I? This is the current I. We need to write the mesh current. So we need to define I1, I2, I3. Look, I1 is counterclockwise. I1, CCW. I2, CW. I3, CCW. And some of them clockwise, some is counterclockwise. You will write equation of mesh 1. Look, where is mesh 1? Mesh 1? Mesh 1 is here. So I will move counterclockwise. So you will have 2 ohms. Look at 2 ohms. 2 ohms has 2 current. What are the current in the 2 ohms? I1 plus I2. Because I1 is moving clockwise and I2 is moving counterclockwise. Sorry, counterclockwise and the clockwise. The current, the resistor R2, 2 ohms, has 2 current. I1 plus I2. Tamam? So 2 I1 plus I2, then you will move in the 1 ohms. What is the current in the 1 ohms when you move counterclockwise? Is I1 minus I3. The current in the 1 ohm is I1 minus I3. Even it has been written here, I1 minus I3. So plus I1, I3, it should be here minus 3 or equal to 3. For mesh number 2, the second mesh here. Second mesh, we will move. We'll move again clockwise. Move clockwise with the current I2. When you move clockwise, when you move in the 2 ohms, what is the current in the 2 ohms? Clockwise, I2 plus I1. So 2I2 plus I1. Down here, Ashman. So 2I2 plus I1. Then you move in the 3 ohms. What is the current in the 3 ohms? I2 moving down and I3 moving down. So the current in the 3 ohms is I2 plus I3. What's the current in the 1 ohm? I2 only. And the mesh 3, what about mesh 3? You move counterclockwise. So it will be 1 ohm times I3 minus I1. And when you move here, I'm writing the equation of mesh 3. So it will be 1 ohm times I3 minus I1, because I'm moving this way. So I will take I3 minus I1. Then you move down, you move in the 3 ohm. So plus 3, what's the current in the 3 ohm, mesh current moving down? It will be I2 plus I3. Minus 2 equal to 0. This is the mesh equation in loop 3. So you will have 3 equations and 3 unknowns. Just solve them and again, you can repeat using nodal analysis. Repeat this equation using nodal at home. Repeat using node analysis or node method and see how long it will take. Your expectation, it will take shorter time or more time. What's your expectation? Here, how many questions? How many questions I need to solve here? How many questions, Shabay? 3 questions and 3 unknowns. We need calculator and stuff. So let's repeat. I will do it for you. It's the same problem here. Use nodal. How many essential nodes we have? How many essential nodes? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we need to choose one as a reference node. I'm going to choose this as a reference node. Tamam? Use this as a reference node. Now, do we have a free answer here? If you use this as a reference node, what will be VC? What's VC here?
Minus 3.
VC is 2. Because it's a reference. So VC is 2. Free equation. Free unknown. Tamam? VC equal to 2 volt. This source, what is VA minus VC? When you move this way, VA minus VC is 3. This will give you, and VC is known. So VA is 5. So in no time, you will find 2 unknowns. In no time, you will find 2 unknowns. تمام. What is the left? What's the remaining? Find VB. How can I find VB? How can I find VB? KCL. KCL at this node. KCL. You will find this current plus this current, but this current equal to zero. Remember, you already found the VA and VC. This problem is very, very easy using nodal. It will take 1 minute to solve using nodal analysis. If you take this as a reference, VC is given. VC is 2 volt. And the VA minus VC, look here, this is like super node, VA minus VC equal to 3. So VA is given as well. Because VC is known. VC is 2. So VA is 5. So no time you have found 2 unknowns. What is VB? Take KCL here. This current plus this current plus this current equal to 0. Anyone can tell me what is KCL at node B? What's KCL at node B, Shabab?
VB minus VA over 2.
Exactly.
And VB minus VC over 1. And VB over 3.
So KCL at node B, Shabab, as this guy was saying, it will be VB minus VA over 2 plus VB over 3 plus VB minus VC over 1. Equal to zero. Remember, you already have VA and VC. So how many unknown in this circuit? Only VB. How many unknown in the last equation? Only VB. So using nodal analysis in this circuit, it will take, how long it will take to solve this? To solve one equation, not unknown. How long this will take using nodal to find the nodal, to find this free voltage? Huh? How long it will take, Shabab?
3 minutes, maybe.
1 minute. This problem take 1 minute. Not 3 minutes. What 3 minutes? If you are wise enough to choose what is the reference node, you will find it very easy to find VC. And VA minus VC is 3 volt. Yani, these two equations will take 10 seconds to write. And then you solve for VB using this equation. Of course, if you have a good practice, and if you have put some time to solve homework and practice, this problem will take 1 minute. 2 minutes, okay, 2 minutes for the average student. It will take 2 minutes. How long it took to you if you use mesh? Look how long it will took from you. Using mesh, it will take at least 5 minutes to solve this using mesh analysis. 5 minutes with the good student. Maybe 6 to 7 minutes with the average student. So in some what I'm saying here, you can solve this problem in 2 minutes or 7 minutes. So you have to choose. تمام؟ أي سؤال يا شباب؟ We finish the class.
Yes, doctor.
Yes.
Doctor, I have a question.
So يعني, شباب, class finish. Class finish. If you want to go, you can go. If you want to stay and it's solid, you can stay. Yes.
Okay. In the exam, doctor, he will give me that I1 plus I2, and he will tell.
No, I will usually we don't give this. You give only the circuit, and you manage yourself. Yeah.
Okay.
Usually, yeah. Usually we don't give this current. Only give the circuit, and you manage. You choose your current, and you choose mesh or node or whatever.
Okay.
Shabab, it's about time. It's not about how to solve. It's about how long this will take from you. In exam, if I give you this and I know it will take 2 minutes using nodal, I will give you 2 minutes. I will assume this take 2 minutes. If you do the wrong choice and use mesh, it's your problem. Clear? Is this clear? يعني أنت لازم يكون لديك نوع من الوزدم الحكمة يعني. والله يؤتي الحكمة لمن إيه؟
يشاء.